no longer the case as we look at the freeze and hard freeze warnings across the state right now. No matter which color purple you have overhead, you have a freeze warning. And these freeze warnings, mainly for the ag community here, now that we have already started our growing season, all right, now things are turning green, you can certainly get quite a bit of damage done to your vegetation with these type of freezes coming in here. So you certainly want to make sure that you are protecting your plants and crops out there for this evening. If you wake up in the morning and you notice that your plants outside were damaged from this cold, they're actually very resilient. So a lot of them will be able to recover. It's just going to take a little while, and you may have some stunted growth there for a little while. So lows tonight, 27 degrees in Enid. That's pretty cold. 23 in Ponca City, 27 in Stillwater, 31 in Seminole, right here in Oklahoma City, 28 degrees. And again, those winds only around 5 and 15 miles per hour. There is a moon overhead. And again, that moon is going to be turning red. It's going to be an eclipse. I know a lot of times we want to give it a name. We've given it the blood moon, but it's actually a lunar eclipse out there. So 30 degrees at 8 a.m. You need to start that heater early in your car tomorrow as you're driving into work. It's going to take a little while if you jump into your car right away and get that heat coming out of the vents by noon. 58 degrees, and temperatures are going to quickly climb into the lower 60s tomorrow. So while it will be a cold start, it will be a decent finish. Highs in the lower 60s, those winds around 10 and 20 miles per hour. Out in Clinton tomorrow, climbing up to 64 degrees, 66 in Woodward, 63 from Enid, Stillwater, and Ponca City. Will you need to protect your plants as we go into Wednesday morning? More than likely, you will not have to. We will stay above freezing here, down to 40 degrees in Enid, 40 in Stillwater, 37 degrees right here in Oklahoma City. Those winds, they're not going to be strong tomorrow, but they will be picking back up tomorrow night and into Wednesday. Now, your sweet potato vines may not appreciate these type of temperatures, but again, they should be okay. Their leaves may turn brown and wilt, but again, the plant itself should be able to regrow there. So highs as we go into Wednesday, 69 degrees in Stillwater, 69 in Ponca City, warmer in western Oklahoma, climbing into low to mid 70s. So temperatures are coming up, but then they start falling down again. As we go into Thursday, most of us will see a chance for some scattered showers north of I-40 here. Extreme northwestern Oklahoma, we're talking about Woodward, a chance of a rain, then changing over to a rain-snow mix as we go into Thursday here. But for many of us, we will not see that type of snow coming in that we had for today, and there will not be any severe weather. You can see the storm impacts for Thursday. We are not registering any type of tornado, hail, wind, or flooding risk. So your 7-day forecast, after a cold start to the day for tomorrow, we climb up to 63 degrees for a high. Gorgeous afternoon, sunny skies as we go into Wednesday, 67 degrees, 40% chance of rain as we go into Thursday, 62 degrees. Headed into Easter weekend, chance of rain and thunderstorms comes in here late Saturday and into Sunday. Those sunrise services for Sunday, we'll have to watch them pretty closely. There is a chance of rain and thunderstorms Sunday morning. And you're up to date with the latest First Alert forecast.